Bankers issue seismic warning. Bitcoin, Ethereum, BNB, Cardano, and XRP could replace the dollar in just 5 years. We need to talk about this here today. This is something that I just saw for the first time. It just came out yesterday, and it's pretty big. The implications of this are massive, and it's something that we have to discuss. This is very bullish for crypto, and I would want to break it down a little bit, what this could actually mean for crypto. And this is something that a lot of us saw already, right? We saw digital currencies, decentralized currencies, maybe taking over in the 21st century. But this is really interesting to see this from the bankers, which is why we have to talk about it. Now, if you guys don't mind, hit the like button. I really appreciate it. It really is bullish here, what we're seeing here. Also, if you want to take full advantage of cryptocurrency and the massive gains that you're going to get in the future, you really do want to set up some account that you can get interest. So you can check out the link down below to BlockFi where you can get interest rates on your cryptocurrencies. That's going to make a huge difference as time goes on. And they have the Bitcoin back rewards card there. Definitely check that out underneath the video. Now, cryptocurrencies are staying steady, right? We have Bitcoin around 49,000, Ethereum around 3,300, Cardano at just under $3, Binance right under 500. Now, I've been consistently dollar cost averaging. Even today I bought some. And we need to take a look at some of the massive news today. This is not the only news. We have some news, some big news coming here in 2 weeks. We have some big news from some of the largest companies in the world. So this is coming out of Deloitte, one of the massive accounting firms. We uncovered several findings that illustrate a seismic shift in financial services resulting from the evolution of blockchain-based digital assets. They found in this report 76% of finance professionals think Bitcoin and crypto could serve as an alternative or replacement for fiat currencies in the next 5 to 10 years. A strong majority, 81% of the almost 1,300 executive questions think blockchain, the technology that underpins Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies, is broadly scalable and has already achieved mainstream adoption. Meanwhile, 73% think that their company should adopt crypto or blockchain or risk losing competitive advantage. The foundation of banking has been fundamentally outlived, and financial services industry players must redefine themselves and find innovative ways to create economic growth in the future of money. This is fascinating because we have seen this coming to fruition. I've been talking about it on the channel. We've seen all the massive banks do a couple things. First of all, they said Bitcoin's gonna fall, cryptos are gonna fall. It's all fake money. You know, it's just a ploy to get your money. It's a Ponzi scheme. And at the same time, we saw them set up different things for their wealthier clients, right? Different Bitcoin funds, crypto funds, stuff like that. And then all of a sudden, they all are bullish on crypto, right? We could see this coming. You don't set something up for your wealthy, most important clients and then go spread a lot of fear, uncertainty, and doubt. None of these banks now are saying, hey, Bitcoin's gonna fall. Right? They're all saying now, hey, this could replace the US dollar. They're trying to get in on it now. And you have to be careful because they could always do something sketchy here in the future, which is go short Bitcoin or short cryptos and then spread some fear, uncertainty, and doubt. But that's going to be very hard to orchestrate. At this point, it was really easy because no one had wealthy clients that were going really heavily into crypto, at least through their own company. But after they start adding it and they're helping clients buy crypto, right? If JP Morgan Chase came out and said Bitcoin's gonna fall to 40,000, then every other big bank said, no, it's going up to 60. that wouldn't push the price of Bitcoin down most likely. Now, what we have to look at here is what this could mean if it really does replace the US dollar. So we can see that this is actually as of 2017. I couldn't find anything newer than this. According to the CIA, the total amount of money is about $80 trillion if you include broad money. So $80 trillion, that's a large market. We also have all the money that's been printed over the last couple of years, especially last year and then the beginning of this year. We're talking trillions and trillions of dollars. So $80 trillion, and then the US alone printed like 5 or 10 trillion over last year. So we're looking at over $100 trillion. Now, just a representation here of how much money that actually is. This is $100 million. This is $100 million, which is 1 year of work for 3,500 people. This is 3,500 people. This is $1 billion. This is the $27 billion that was printed a day in 2020 by the, I believe this is just by the US government. Yeah, so just the US government, because they said they would print up to 10.5 trillion. $1 trillion right here. This is a person right here. And then we have $2 trillion emergency stimulus package. Look how much this is. This is a house right here. You can see everything else here. So you can see how large all this money actually is. So what could that mean for the cryptocurrency market? Well, if it replaces and we just get up to $100 trillion, right? $100 trillion, that would be a 50X from here. We would see a lot of that money going to Bitcoin. We'd see a lot of it going to some of the highest quality projects. Obviously, some of these other smaller projects will get pumped up more if we really do see $100 trillion, because there'd be so much volume. You would need projects that could scale. You would need projects that are very high quality. Now, we probably wouldn't see 50Xs in some of the crappier coins, right? I don't think all the meme coins would necessarily go up 50X, right? But we would see things like Bitcoin that could potentially go up to 2.5 million, assuming we actually got to a $100 trillion market cap and it really did replace actual fiat. Now, I think that's a little bit of manipulation to say, okay, 5 years from now, 2026, crypto is going to be $100 trillion, then fiat is going to be, you know, a couple trillion. I don't think that's going to happen. I think it's going to take longer than that, but that is still really bullish. And one thing to think about is, hey, maybe they're just trying to manipulate the market. And now that they've actually bought in and started to get some crypto, you can see that they have manipulated markets for years. I mean, you can take a look at some of the biggest banks and they've been manipulating for years. But one thing to think about is now they are manipulating for us instead of against us if you hold cryptocurrencies. So that is most likely more bullish than it is bearish, right? That's a good thing for cryptocurrency holders. Now, perfect world, we wouldn't have manipulation. There would be no fear, uncertainty, and doubt. We would just see like a little gradual increase and maybe a little bit of a decrease and a little bit of an increase. But we wouldn't see all this fear out there. But there's still some people that are adding. I mean, we know that the banks are adding. They're selling to their wealthier clients. I've been dollar cost averaging. We see here MicroStrategy has purchased an additional almost 4,000 Bitcoin for $177 million in cash at an average of $45,000 per Bitcoin. That is almost double. So about 80% more expensive than their average price for Bitcoin so far. We are still in a very good place moving forward. Michael Saylor is still purchasing more Bitcoin. You don't have to be worried. He is still adding. He still thinks it is undervalued. He thinks that this is a $100 trillion asset. He talked about that recently. This is a $100 trillion asset. In addition to that, we have El Salvador moving forward with Bitcoin law in exactly 2 weeks from today. So they will have 200 ATMs, 50 in-person kiosks, and this is going to launch September 7. The government will facilitate the buying and selling of Bitcoin without collecting any commission, which is great. I mean, this could be a money ploy, right? But it's not. It could be, right? They could be charging 1% fees, 2% fees, but they're not doing that. So that's something to consider. 2 weeks from now, very bullish looking for Bitcoin. Now, we have a lot of different projects that are going through important dates here soon. We have Ethereum 2.0 coming in the coming months, most likely probably like 6 months, you know, 3 to 6 months. We have Cardano with smart contracts, and all that pales into comparison to the hype that is growing in the NFT space. I just want to talk about this. Some big things happening. Visa enters the metaverse with their first NFT purchase. So they bought a $150,000 CryptoPunk. Something interesting about this is they had to buy it with Ethereum, right? They had to have Ethereum to buy this. So that's pretty interesting. Maybe we get news of Visa buying Bitcoin and Ethereum next quarter. Otherwise, they could have just bought it to buy this CryptoPunk, but still pretty interesting that they are getting into this. Now, they said that they have collections of various, essentially art, over time and different interesting things, and they want to add this to their collection. This is pretty bullish though for NFTs. In addition to that, we have some other things that are just going, some other NFTs are going crazy. EtherRock 42 purchased for 400 Ether. You can hold this JPEG for $1 million, $1.3 million, this picture. and you own that. Pretty interesting, right? I mean, that tells you how crazy this is, how many people have made money in cryptocurrency that they're willing to spend $1.3 million on this rock. Then we have Punk 6965, which has a bid of 2,000 ETH, which is nearly $7 million right here. $7 million for this CryptoPunk. So overall, the market is looking bullish. We have people making so much money there, spending millions on JPEGs, millions and millions and millions. I mean, you could buy a mansion for that. It's crazy. It's crazy. But we are in a very bullish time. Don't get it twisted. There's a lot of potential out there. Even if we don't replace the world's fiat currency, there's still a lot of potential out there and a lot of upside appreciation. I mean, think about it this way. How long will it take you to 2x an index fund? Usually 10 years, right? Last year was really good. So actually average out, might be a little bit worse in the future, but usually it takes 7 to 10 years to double in an index fund. How soon do you think we could hit $100,000 Bitcoin? How soon do you think we could hit $6,000 Ethereum or $7,000 Ethereum? That's a 2x. I think we're going to hit that before we see a double in index funds. I could always be wrong, but that is why I am investing so much into cryptocurrencies, not only for the upside appreciation, but because I also see the world changing. I see this as a good way to hedge against inflation and to get on the right side of innovation. There are a lot of reasons to be interested and bullish in this space. But let me know your thoughts. What are you most bullish on down below? Let me know if you have any NFTs. I'd be interested in hearing that. Thank you guys so much. Definitely check out the link down below to BlockFi to get an interest rate on your cryptos. And there's a link down there to the BlockFi rewards card. Definitely check that out too. I really suggest if you guys want a new credit card or if you want to get Bitcoin back without having to actually buy it, it's definitely a good way to go. There's no annual fee. Thank you guys, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.